discuss about the lens maker formula. And why do we call it lens maker formula? Because the lens is made of glass and it has the radii of curvature. So if we have a relation which shows the relationship between material of the lens and that, the radii of curvature is called the lens maker formula. The formula which shows the relation relationship among the radii of curvature and material of lens is called lens maker formula. Lens maker formula. So this we will derive, and here I will tell you that this formula is derived in the two cases. First case is when the medium on both side of the lens is the same, and second when the medium on both side of the lens is different. So first we will take first. Lens maker formula when the medium on both sides of lens is same. This is the lens L, M1, N, L, L, M2, N. This is the first surface, this is the second surface. The first surface will have the center of curvature at this point. Suppose this is now your center of curvature is C1. Then this is now radius of curvature R1. Now for second one, this will have the center of curvature here, C2. So this is now radius of curvature R2. Radius of curvature R2. Let's, here is some point. Now let this is now object O, and the light ray from here. So first they will bend towards this normal that we have here. So the light ray will be, this will be the normal, then light ray will bend in this way. So it will make the image I dash. Then because of this second surface, the lattice will bend further. So here will be the image I. This is now optical center. This is now ODS. This is now suppose O. So what we have? This distance is equal to U. And this distance is B dash. And this distance is B. This is now so much is B. So what we have? We have are having the two surfaces, LM1N and LM2N. For LM1N, the center of curvature is this C1, this is the radius of curvature R1. For LM2N, the center of curvature is C2, the radius of curvature R2. Here is the object, and the frontal image of this object is being formed. That is now I. Because of this LM1N, the image is at I dash. And for LM2N, finally the image is formed at this point I. This is now your real image, as you see from here. So this is now virtual image. So for refraction through spherical surface. Now here we have the U formula, this mu 2 upon V minus mu 1 upon U equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 upon R. We will use this formula. This is now formula number 1 that we will use it here. So now we come. And here is refractive index mu 1, here is refractive index this mu 1, and the refractive index of this glass that is equal to mu 2. So here we will have this mu 2. This is now mu 2. So the medium on both sides of the lens, or left side or the right side, we are having the same medium. So it will have the refractive index mu 1 and mu 1. And the material of this lens, that is the refractive index mu 2. So for surface LM1N, using the distribution, using one. This is now 1. What we have? This is now your lattice going from mu 1 to mu 2. So this is your equal to mu 2 upon V dash minus mu 1 upon U equal to, this is now your mu 2 minus mu 1 upon R1. This is now R1. This is so much is R1. This is now second. Now then for surface LM2N, for LM2N, what we have? Again we use this formula first. Using the first formula, we will have this. Then now light ray will go from mu 2 to mu 1. In the first case, light ray are going from mu 1 to mu 2. And now for second, light ray are going from mu 2 to mu 1. So this will change. In place of mu 1, we will write down mu 2. In place of mu 2, we will write down this mu 1. And here, this u will be v dash. This will act as the object for this surface LM2N. So what we have? That this mu 2, in place of this, we will write down this mu 1. And in place of mu 1, we write down this mu 2, and this u equal to v dash, and v is equal to v.
mu 1 upon v minus mu 2 upon v dash equal to. Now first here this was the mu 2 minus mu 1. Now here will be this mu 1 minus mu 2 upon r. This is the first second surface. This is our relation number 3. So now we add second and 3. Adding 2 and 3. What we have is mu 2 upon vds, mu 2 upon vds will cancel. So we will have this mu 1 upon b minus mu 1 upon u is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 upon r1 plus mu 1 minus mu 2 upon r2. Now you take mu 1 common. This is equal to 1 upon v minus 1 upon u equal to, we can write to this one, this mu 2 minus mu 1 into 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. So we will have this mu 1. Now this 1 upon v minus 1 upon u, this is equal to the focal length. As we know, this is now from formula. This is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 upon mu 1 into 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. This is the general formula. This is the general formula. And now if suppose on this mu 1 and mu 2, they are here we have the air, this is now also now this set here, then mu 1 will be equal to 1. So taking mu 1 equal to 1 for here and mu 2 equal to mu, or simply this is the refractive index of the glass. So we can write down to be more better is a mu g. Then this 1 upon f equal to mu minus 1 into 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. This is not for this. So this we have taken when the medium on both sides of the lens is the same. Suppose the medium is different. So now we take the second situation. Lens maker formula. When medium on both sides of lens is different. This we have to take. So for this what we have? Suppose this is now lens. This is now lens. And this is now your L, M1, N, and L, M2, N, this is now so much. Now here we have the medium like this one. Refractive index mu 1. This is our medium. And now here we will have the medium like this. This is our medium mu 2. Then what we will have? The only difference will be what? While using this one, Now this has again, this is the center of curvature, this is now your C2, C1. This is now center of curvature, suppose this is now your C2. And this is now object, this is now principle. And this is now, suppose, this is now mu3, this is now mu3. And this is the refractive index, mu2, mu2. Refractive index, mu2. So this will be now your mu2 upon v dash minus mu1 upon u equal to mu2 minus mu1 upon r1. This we have used the relation number 1 as I told you. For surface L M to N. Now what we are doing? We are going from mu2 to mu3. Light rays go from mu2 to mu3. So now this will be changed. So this will have this mu3 upon v minus mu2 upon v dash equal to, this is now your mu3 minus mu2 upon radius r2. This is what surface area I am doing. So now again adding, this is now your relation number 3, this is now relation number 4, this is now your 4 and this is now 5. So adding,
numerical questions on which that this formula can be used. So we
have the use of both the formula. This one is, so this formula is most prominent. Most prominent. And this formula is not so much used. But in some numerical question, this may be used. So, this is about the lens maker formula. When the medium on both sides of the lens is the same, or when the medium are the different. So, thank you very much.